Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be showing you how we use WhatIF in Genesys. We'll start by setting up a WhatIF synthesis for receiver system. We'll show you how we select the mixer types, determine the spurious free IF range. We'll select and set up a dual band RF receiver, and then optimize the settings for improved performance. Before system level design is started, the various IF bands need to be determined. WhatIF is a tool to help us determine the spurious free IF bands available for use. After that, ello frequencies and system component parameters may be determined. From the workspace tree, we'll select synthesis and then WhatIF planner. We'll select the factory default values, press OK, which brings up the properties dialog. We can change the name or accept it, as well as the data set, the intermediate frequency of the mixers, either at the input or the output, depending on whether it's up or down converter. We can look at all the intermediate frequencies or just choose a particular IF. We can also select the number of parallel input mixers from 1 to 5, the spurious order that are used for mixing from 1 up to 20, and we can set our spurious free amplitude range, as we see here, to 100. For inputs, we can select either the difference or the sum frequency, depending on whether we're going to up convert, down convert. In this case, if we select the difference, we can have the ello on the high side or the low side of the RF signal. Now we're going to select our RF center frequency at 2400 megahertz. We're going to select an RF bandwidth of 100 megahertz and an IF bandwidth of 2 megahertz. Our input drive level, we're going to start with minus 20 dB and set the ello at 10 dB. For the mixer, we have a choice of either using the built-in available double balance mixer, which we can set some of the parameters on, or we can use a set of table-based mixers. Selecting the intermod table, we can browse through a list of library components from various manufacturers. In this example, we're going to use a Hittite table-based mixer. And then we need to just scroll down and select one of the mixers that will work within our frequency range. And in this case, we want it to be a double balance mixer. This looks like it would work. Okay, going back to the inputs and applying that, you see the results of this first mixer. The green bands represent our spurious free range down to minus 100 dBc. The blue lines represent mixing products that are mixing products of our LO and RF various combinations. If we hover the mouse over each of these, we can see their level as well as their mixing products. That is, what are the range of IF or LO and RF frequencies that produce those. Okay, if I now change the input drive level, let's say to minus 10 dBm, and then apply that, we can see how it changes the width of the available IFs and, for a higher power level. If we drop it back down to 20, then of course the IF widths change appropriately because the amount of interference that is called, or spurs that occur, are different. Let's change the amplitude range for a spurious free range to 80 and apply that, and notice that our IF ranges have increased tremendously over, you know, from 66 megahertz up to almost 600 for the lowest one. And if we drop that back down to 100, now we can see the shift in the available IF frequencies. What I'm doing now is limiting our y-axis to 3 gigahertz. We only want to be interested in ranges up to 3 gigahertz for this example. Okay. What I'm going to do now is add a second mixer. From the Settings tab, we select 2 for the number of parallel input mixers. And then we go to Inputs, and you see we have 2 mixers now. We'll select the second mixer. We'll leave it as a difference product in the LO below the RF. We'll set the center frequency to 5300 megahertz. And the IF to 400 megahertz, and the IF to 2. And you might guess we're making a dual band Wi-Fi here. And input level to minus 20. And then the next step is to select the mixer type. And we'll do the same thing as we did before, intermod table. We'll scroll down through the mixer table types and select one that works over our band. In this case, the lower one here is 4 to 7 gigahertz. That'll meet our requirements. And so we've added a second mixer. When I apply the IF synthesis, you notice we don't have any IFs that appear below 3 gigahertz. So we run into a problem. The red lines here represent the spur levels as well as the various mixing products that as ello and IF that produce those. So let's try to do something like change the ello to IF, that is, make the ello larger, higher than the IF, and lo and behold, we do get a IF somewhere around 900 megahertz and up around 2 gigahertz. This is for 850 to 900. It gives us a 500 megahertz window. Let's do the same with the first mixer. Apply that, and notice that now our IF, available IF, is wider. It's from 800 to 975 as far as the lowest IF. If we relax our spec and drop that to 80 dB and then apply, now notice our IF, available IF, has gotten even wider and given us more latitude in where we can place our IF signal. Okay, having arrived at one possible set of IF frequencies that we can use for this particular setup and design, let's look and see what our schematic looks like, that is, what the dual input looks like. And you see here is an example of the two mixers going into a single IF. I hope I showed you how valuable a tool WhatIF is in your system design. Thanks for watching.